every day we hear, observe, and discover through various media outlets. We've become conditioned to accept media's ethos as our own, incorporating racial farces into daily interactions, correlating its themes to reality. We've become incognizant to the message of oppression we help spread. So we wanted to ask, how does racism affect you?
Live right now, this inside of LSU student union with wild packs of future freshmen appearing.
What is your view of an average American?
Average white guy.
Everything's a melting pot, so an American is any culture that comes here to work for their dreams.
Has the media portrayed certain ethnicities negatively?
I often see in the media how Middle Eastern races are typically portrayed as, you know, more criminal and violent, and it's just one of the most common misportrayals of a race.
Fox.
Okay.
They're so right-wing that every time they bring up the word Arab or, like, you know, Pakistani, they show somebody blowing something up, or it's always like when they say Obama, they say Obama, like, they don't say Barack Obama, they say Barack Hussein Obama.
I do feel like, you know, a lot of times, you know, not only black people, but a lot of people, like Hispanic people, Asian people, like, there are a lot of jokes at their expense, and while it is funny, it's like, to a certain degree, like, there's definitely racist implications to them, and it's not good stuff.
Well, one thing I think I've noticed is that there really isn't a multiracial representation in media. It's either you are black or you are white. There is no, oh, she's mixed. They try to either label you as, like, oh, you are more black, or oh, you are more white. And that goes even to, like, from the way you look down to the way you speak. So it's really interesting to try to characterize you by one, even though you can be made of, like, multiple things.
Typically, you hear more about Mexicans with illegal immigration and immigration law and labor workers.
Make it seem like you're all across the border to come here. You don't have papers, and you're doing bad for the country, taking away people's jobs.
It's one thing to say, oh yeah, he's black, but it's another thing to say, oh yeah, he's black, so he must like fried chicken and watermelon, or he's Asian, so he must be good at math, or, you know, it's a little offensive, I guess. Like, if you have a sense of humor, you can shake it off, because, you know, you're used to it, but some people just really do take offense to it.
The media, television, period, you know, like, they have shows where they do like comical plays where the black guy's like the entertainer or stuff like that, but they never really portray him as the intellectual unless it's a really decent show. Like the whole Trayvon Martin case, like, they put up his obituary pictures, which was a very childish picture. They look nice, you know, but it's some of the media, they're putting up like thuggish pictures of him. You know, he's passed, so you have to have some respect, and they didn't have respect for him, and I really didn't like that.
Is it okay that popular shows poke fun at various ethnic groups?
No, I laugh at all of them because, I mean, I guess you could take it in stride as long as it's not anything that's overtly discriminatory or overtly racist. You know, you have to have that ability to laugh things off. Like, I guess Jasmine on the Boondocks, you know, as an example, people call her High Yellow. That's fun. You know, it's just how it's seen, but as long as you're still, as long as it's lighthearted, I guess it's really no problem.
This is my standpoint on it. There's a right way to do things, there's a wrong way to do things. Like Chappelle's show, it's kind of iffy. Like, he crosses a lot of lines that he shouldn't. And I feel like if you're going to do something like that, it has to be in good nature, because you never know how you may affect someone. Somebody could commit suicide over it. If you're going to do a comical thing, because that's where everybody try to make it out, and a lot of times, if you look it up, it's like a statistic, 50% of the time, or maybe 70% of the time, I'm not sure, when you're being funny, you're being serious. Mm-hmm. So, you know, there's no reason for you to make jokes about it when people can actually tell that you're being serious. If you're going to do something like that, be more responsible.
As soon as you said me, I think of the show Everybody Hates Chris. And it's true, I laugh at that show. I think it's hilarious, but the entire show is based off of black stereotypes. Like, they all beat their children, they all have high, like, anger problems, and the dad's never there because he's working, and I don't know, it's really funny. At the same time, it's kind of sad because I really do think that it shapes the mindset of like how we view each other's culture. And I mean, the story can go on and on, like, because there's even Caucasians portrayed in that show, and so they're all super clean cut and they don't express themselves very much. They kind of just like fall in line with like what they're supposed to do. It is funny, but it really does shape the way we see each other.
Have you ever personally dealt with a racism?
I was in middle school, well actually it happened in high school too, and one of the teachers was going off about how people were losing their chances of tops and things like that, and they were letting Hispanics and other immigrants take their jobs that are made for Americans. And I actually went to the principal, let him know, and I got switched out of that class.
I've often been claimed a racist whenever I've disagreed with a person of a different race, just because I guess that's the natural retaliation is to call somebody a racist if they don't agree with your own views and your racism views, or anybody of your races, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I have, like, throughout my life, just nothing real major, but I mean, like, going into, like hairdressers, and they say, we don't do your kind of hair, you know?
I grew up in a black household, I guess you could say. And I mean, I was never a bad kid, but when I had got in trouble, you know, I got a spanking. And that's just the way it was. And when I see it portrayed in the media, it's like, oh, I can identify with that. And when I see a white parent like, no, Jimmy, you've got to go to timeout. You know, it's like, timeout, you know, I've got the belt, you know. And it's just, I guess it's just how each side learns, you know, it's you have the black side and you have the white side. Depends on which side you're on.
Yeah, it's really funny that you say that. I grew up with the majority of white friends, though. And so I have had white friends where they got worse beatings, I feel, than I did. Like, I got a belt. They got, like, paddles and, like, these pieces of wood. Like, I would die if my mom came in the room with a piece of wood and was like, come here. So, I don't know. I think it's kind of funny, like, because I would assume, like, you know, like, the average white parent would, because in media you see them say, like, oh, get in the corner, Jimmy. Like, shame on you. Give me your hand.
I'm Chaz Nichols, and I'm actually interracial between black and white.
My name is Eric Jamal Kuto. My ethnicity is African American and Native American.
My name is Rita Queen, and I am half black and half white.
My name is Daniel Brown, and I'm mixed with about everything that you can think of. Black, Spanish, French, and Native American.
My name is Nicholas George. I am from Lake Charles, Louisiana, and I am Caucasian Lebanese.
Zeeshan Shaheed, my family's from Pakistan.
My name is Nimi Cabrera, I'm from Honduras, and I'm Hispanic.
It's halftime, America. Let's put racism where it needs to be, in the ground. So what are you going to do about it?